Jurassic Encounter is a large-scale outdoor touring animatronic dinosaur show. So it's both educational and entertainment. So we call it an edutainment event. So every dinosaur, we have about 50 in total, approximately, and each one comes with its own information panel, gives in-depth information about the dinosaur so that people can learn, visitors can learn about the dinosaurs as they walk around. It's a walk-through trail right across the park. So we're launching in London, of course, first in 2 weeks' time, and then we're touring to Cardiff after London, then Glasgow, then finishing the tour in Birmingham in October. I mean, all the animatronic dinosaurs, they have moving parts. So, for example, arms move, you've got the breathing effect, so you can see the stomach sort of expanding and coming back in again slightly, just like a human body. You have the head bobbing up and down, going left to right. You've got roaring sound effect. The tails are swishing from side to side. So it's very interactive in that sense. And there are lots of other things to do and see at Jurassic Encounter too. It really is. And that's why we need a full 2 weeks to install the show at every venue. I mean, we went on site with our trucks yesterday at Grovelands Park in London, and it's going to take us 2 weeks to install. And then again, same in Cardiff, Birmingham and Glasgow. So it is a mammoth undertaking. They arrive on approximately 7 or 8 40-foot trucks, and they're unloaded. They can come in sections, so it does make life a little bit easier. So the bodies, the heads, the necks, the tails. For the larger dinosaurs, they come in sections. The smaller ones come in one piece. So they're unloaded, and then they're positioned throughout the park in the right places, strategically placed along the route. And we try to create a nice sort of adventure walkthrough of all the dinosaurs. Some of them will be peering out the bushes, others will be amongst the trees with the tall necks amongst the trees. So it's a really interesting, really fun environment for children. They are life-size, and that's what makes them so awesome and amazing to look at up close and personal. When you get up next to it, you realize just how big they are. When you look up at the head of a Diplodocus or the Brachiosaurus, for example, you'll see that they're like 10 to 12 meters up in the skies. So it's quite awesome to see it up close and personal like that. And, you know, children and adults alike find it quite phenomenal. And it's very well attended. And we are expecting, you know, people from all over the country to come and see this event. People realize that they're not just coming along to see dinosaurs. It's a full day out. I like to stress that it is a full day out. So once you arrive, you can stay as long as you like. And the most important thing is that there are other things to do and see there. You know, we have our VR machines where people can have a go and have some VR experiences. There's food and drink stalls there. There's a merchandise trailer there, so you can buy a souvenir of your visit. There's a ride on dinosaurs there. And for younger children, there's a fossil excavation pitch where younger children can play at being mini paleontologists. We all grew up with dinosaurs, and we all have our favorites. And I'm no different. You know, I was in awe of dinosaurs at school, and for me it was always the usual ones: the Triceratops, the Diplodocus, the Brachiosaurus, the giant T-Rex. Those four have always been my favourites, and also, you know, it's reinforced by films like Jurassic Park, where they really play on those strong dinosaurs that are generally known to the public. So look out for those, but just as importantly, you know, I'd urge visitors to look out for the less conspicuous ones, the ones that people don't know so much about, like the Deinonychus and the Styracosaurus, the Iguanodons, the Spinosaurus. You know, we talk about T-Rex, don't forget the Spinosaurus. They used to battle a lot. And lots of other things. You know, we've got a pair of caged velociraptors fighting to break out of a metal cage, which is a great scene. And we've got other dinosaurs that are facing off against each other. So we've created some amazing scenes for visitors to really, you know, interact and get involved and really appreciate what we've done with this show. we talk about this, the Instagram moment at every event. Well, we've got 50 Instagram moments, and that's important to know. And children and adults alike, I know everybody loves to take the picture in front of various their favorite dinosaurs, and they'll post it instantly. So yeah, make sure your phones are fully charged, your cameras are working, come along and post them, and share them as much as you can with your family and friends. And I say, you know, urge others to come and visit, because it will only be there for a few weeks, and once it's gone, it's gone, and we won't be back. So I would urge everyone to come along and enjoy a fantastic day out. And bear in mind, everyone's doing staycations this summer. It really is the perfect day out. So let's hope the weather holds out for us.